I spoke about the lady of, it's embarrassment, but don't worry, God is with you. About miscarriage. God loves you. Come. God loves you. The Lord is with you. Ne? God is with you. I just
it's
want
me,
to...
me, man of God.
I'm just going to minister to you. Don't worry. God is with you. Ne? I'm going to minister to you. Because you'd have a dream. Bad dreams come. Then tomorrow, you know, blood would come out. Blood would come out.
That's true, man of God.
Huh?
That's true.
Blood would come out. God loves you. And then now you'll miscarry. God loves you. Where's your husband?
He's there.
Yeah, come with her. I just want to pray with you. But she's not the only one. Because I realized this is not the person I was looking for. I'm just going to minister to them. Because that one I spoke about embarrassment. It's an embarrassment. And the person I'm talking about, since the last miscarriage, you keep on experiencing a feeling like stroke. It's a feeling like stroke. It's like you're going to get stroke. You get that numbness. Because it's not, I'm going to minister to you. What I'm saying is, the person I'm talking about, that's why I spoke about, it's an embarrassment. But I'm going to minister to the two of you. God is with you. I declare it's over. Before I can finish anything.
Amen. No?
Before I can finish anything. I just want to minister to you. That's what I'm saying now. You get bad dreams. Dreams that are not good. Am I right?
It's true.
Huh?
It's true.
Get bad dreams. And then sometimes when you get these dreams, it will be like, I can see that there's another dream which you'd experience the pain on the chest. Am I right?
It's true.
I think it's the man who's quick.
Yes, it's true.
Am I right?
Yes.
She will get chest pains.
Yes.
Ne? Am I right? So that's what I'm saying now. God is going to, I'm just saying to you now, but the person I'm looking for, it's serious embarrassment because the person is not even married. I'm just trying to, the person I'm talking about is not even married, but I'm going to minister to these ones. You get it? But with you, you get those chest pains. What I'm saying, it's like a dream that comes, it ministers evil on you. Huh?
Yes, it's true.
Huh?
Yeah, it's true.
Huh?
It's true, man of God.
Everything that comes, it ministers evil. But now, that's what I'm saying, that evil manifests in the body, sickness.
Yes, that's it's true, man of God.
Huh?
It's true.
It becomes sickness. So what I'm saying is, it manifests in the spirit, then ultimately it comes in the body.
Yes, that's true, man of God. Yes,
it comes in the body, then she would suffer. Am I right?
That is what is happening.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying now, I'm going to minister to you to just finish these things. But there's the other one. I'll get my fish. She must come together with her husband carrying a baby. Can I have this anointing oil? So I'm giving it to you. You can drink it together before you go to the king's chambers. God loves you. You're from?
From Botswana.
You're from Botswana?
Yes.
God loves you, ne?
Right.
I want you to have this. The king's chambers is going to experience, you know, some new music. God loves you, ne?
Thank you.
I just give this to you, ne? I'm saying it's over.
Amen.
Your deliverance now has removed those bad dreams to come. That's what I'm saying with you. It happens in the spirit. It's a plan to cause you to get sick. It's not only miscarriage. You get sick.
Yeah.
And it starts from the dream. Dreams are like, they appear tomorrow. You're sick.
That's true.
Huh? They appear tomorrow, you're sick. That's what I'm saying. I just canceled all those dreams by the power of the living God.
I receive in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
So you'll bring a testimony right now. That's what I'm saying. Just before you go to the king's chambers, you can just drink, but it's done. It's done already.
Praise the Lord. You can just drink for
extraordinary work.
Oh, yes.
God loves you. Bless you. God is with you. God is with you. Say, love you, Jesus. Say, love you, Jesus. Just believe, all of you, God is with you, ne? God is with you. Amen.
Thank you. Lo rapelle ngwana go ha go a siu
prayed for has just asked the man of God to pray for a sibling who is in ICU.
The word of the Lord locates the one she spoke about right now in ICU to raise her up. In Jesus' name, it's happening now. In Jesus' name. Thank you.
accident. Salah kera accident. So asap.
She was involved in a car accident.
How's the pain now?
It's on my head.
It's gone. Just by putting the bottle. Stand up.
The pain is gone now. She doesn't feel any more pains. She was involved in a car accident. And as you can see, she can now run.
Hila Enkel. Yazama, the pain is leaving. Did he miss? She can't feel the pain anymore. Her ankle was very painful and she had to use that ankle corset on her knee to support it, but now she can walk freely without it.
Blessed viewers at home, this is RTV, where fulfillment is captured. We are here during the training in the matters of the kingdom, anointing oil service. With me, I have my mother, who is going to share a wonderful and powerful experience through the anointing oil, Treasures of Darkness. Could you please kindly tell the viewers what your name is and where you come from?
My name is Happy Ramokoka. I'm from Mabopane.
Okay, so during the administration of the anointing oil, please tell us what really happened there.
When the man of God approached me, he asked me what happened to my leg, and then I told him that I broke my ankle. Then he asked me, do I feel any pain on the ankle? And then I told him that I'm feeling pains, and then he gave me the anointing oil to put on the ankle. Then immediately after putting the oil on the ankle, then the pain started disappearing.
The pain is leaving. Did he miss? She can't feel the pain anymore.
What do they
Her ankle was very painful and she had to use that ankle corset on her knee to support it, but now she can walk freely without it.
Wow, we thank God for that. And so with you said you are carrying here, I see you have an aid that holds your ankle. How long have you been using this thing that aids your ankle?
After I left here, the other time when I was here, I was wearing a cast. Okay. Then the doctor removed the cast and then he gave me this to support my ankle. Okay. So I couldn't walk without the support of this. So after putting the anointing on, then the man of God told me to remove the brace. Then after removing the brace, then I was able to walk without the support of the brace.
Wow, we thank God for your healing. Any words of encouragement to the viewers at home?
Viewers at home, I want to encourage you that you must keep on believing. I came here in the morning believing that my leave has ended. I'm supposed to go to work tomorrow. And I just told myself that before I go to work, I know that my miracle is at Rabboni. So, I came here and now I'm walking without the support of the brace. So let's keep on believing Jesus Christ is alive here at Rabboni.
Okay. Any words you would love to share to the man of God himself?
I would like to thank the man of God for being there for us. Without him, I don't know where would I be. I just want to thank him for the support and for the encouragement and the words, the teaching of today, in fact, is the one that uplifted my faith, that we were encompassed by the love of God. Amen.
Wow. There you have it, viewers at home. Mama here is completely healed, and she is able now to walk without the aid of the brace, which she had been using after experiencing her accident falling, after she removed her cast. But we see that now with her ankle, she's able to stand, which is something she was not able to do without the brace. Well, there you have it. To God be the glory.
I got broken when I was playing soccer, and you prayed for me on Friday during all night prayer. So my leg is fine. I can feel even the bones. The only thing that obstructs me from walking, it's because of this plaster, because it's until here. Yes, my leg is fine. I'm only waiting to remove it on the doctor tomorrow.
Pela dishapelo ausins kisa sa koko sepetele uno le kimi imana.
My sister-in-law is in hospital, she's pregnant.
Thank you.
I've brought these clothes here to be burnt. I used to wear these to church, but I no longer want them. I also don't want to smoke anymore. I also have got a problem with my teeth.
Test. You are free, madam. You are free. Let's live for Jesus.
Amen.
You are blessed.
From Mala, I wanted to see you. Mala. Yes, the two of us.
Okay. Okay, the 14-year-old who's being prayed for says his name is Tiamobukaba, and the previous school changed him to a slow learning school. He can't read or write.
I declare supernatural intelligence from above in Jesus' name. Amen. God is with you.